Hello friends, welcome to this new video tutorial series on Python pattern programming. And this is a new series where we will be learning to print certain patterns and how we can do that in Python and the syntax to do it. I'll show you all the tricks that I use for easy to difficult patterns. So in this first video, we'll see this pattern, how you can print this pattern. You can see here that we will be using two variables here. That is the row variable and the column variable, which you can also take it as I and J. And we have a pattern where the asterisk symbol is getting increased and it is in a perpendicular triangular form. So you can see here that we have the max row here that is equal to 6, and the max asterisk symbol is also equal to 6. So by default, the n value that we will be having here is equal to 6. The first thing is for the row. So the row will be in the range of this n value. So we will be giving the range keyword in Python. And then we have the first value, that is, you can see here, the row is starting from 1 and it is going up to 6. So it is starting from 1 and it is going up to n plus 1. So why I gave n plus 1? Because here in the range keyword, the upper limit exclusive, that is 7, will not be included in this range. Now this for loop, inside this for loop, we have to write the column for loop. So the column for loop will be in the range of what? So you can see here in the question itself that in the first row, we have one asterisk. So the column is equal to the row. So the asterisk would always be equal to the row. That is, here we have row is equal to row variable. So now in this variable, we will be printing a simple asterisk symbol. And we want that after the asterisk, in the second row, third row itself, the asterisk is joined here, concatenated. So in the print function, we have another attribute, that is end attribute. And you just have to give the end is equal to space. Okay, then once the first iteration is over, that is once the first row is over, we need to go on the second line. So for that, we have to a special empty print statement here, and just by writing this print statement here, it will go on the second line. So this loop is over. So I'll run this thing. So you can see here that our program is working fine now. What if you want this input from the user? So simply what I will do here is that I will take this input from the user and we will print the pattern. So I gave 8 here and we can see that we get the pattern we desired. So I hope that this video is clear to you. In the upcoming videos, we'll be seeing more patterns, more difficult patterns, one by one. If you still have any doubts in this video, you can write in the comment section. I'll try to solve it. If you like my videos, please do hit the like, share and subscribe button.